Welcome back, guys. Continuing on this British Empire campaign. We've got a fairly large battle to start with. They haven't got quite as many ships as I have, but we've got a couple of battleships. I think I've got the advantage here, though. Well, I completely forgot I have to refit all of these ships. So they've got terrible torpedo range. taking a couple of really big hits on these two. This one's practically dead. This one's lost its torpedoes. Well, he didn't take a torpedo, he just obviously took a big hit. Well, they're getting absolutely wrecked. Must be the veterancy. Either that or they've just got much better ships than the Germans. Well, having this much shorter torpedo range is proving to be a big problem. Well, he doesn't want to fire it. He doesn't want to fire even though he's in absolutely perfect position for a torpedo. So we lost a couple of ships there, and we struggled to get any torpedoes off, but all in all, pretty successful. Just need to refit these damn ships. I think I might have a look to see if there's any more stuff I can refit it with. Okay. So these have been changed. So now nothing fits. That's fantastic. Oh dear. It's probably not worth it then. Yeah, it's almost definitely not worth it. Yeah, everything's so specific on this ship that it's just simply not worth updating. Have a look at the armoured cruiser though. I might be. That's a bit annoying. I mean, I suppose I could give them torpedoes. I've got the auxiliary engine. I've actually got more displacements. So I might want to just build a new design, I don't know. Get enhanced reloading. Got TNT now. Unfortunately, I can't put it down anywhere to be able to compare. That's really annoying. So I can't just like hover over this and then hover over one of them. That is annoying. I think it's slightly better. Oh, there we go. It's got significantly higher accuracy and damage. It's only slightly worse on the reload time. Why is that? Oh, yeah. I think it's because of the army. Yep. 10, 5, 10. So, yeah, it's 100 tons heavier. That's 200 tons, so I can easily afford it. I think it's probably worth doing it. Don't think I need that much armor piercing though, so I could cut back on this. If I'm fighting at like 3,000 to 5,000 range. So they've probably got 75% potentially. Oh, that's only 5%. So they've got about 80%. So if they've got a battleship with 10, then they'd have 18. So yeah, I probably don't need. What would that give it? That's dropped it absolutely massive amount. /24 to /20, that's much better. So standard AP. So yeah, I think I might do that. Increase that. I don't think there's any point in taking these. And what the speed's like, 23.7. There we go, perfect. The four weight is a bit high. Pretty good to me. I've got 4 CLs repairing. Gonna need to refit them once they've repaired. And then I think we're good to go. Ah. All of the armoured cruisers are obviously not wanting to fight because they've been told to refit. So I'm going to have to send them back to refit. It's not a problem, I can just fight with the light cruisers. Yeah, these Austro-Hungarian ships are way more dangerous than the Germans. Well, I'd say that's pretty successful. Mission complete in my eyes. Lost two light cruisers, but not a big deal. Three destroyers managed to escape. 32.5 knots. I'm not chasing them down. Interesting. I didn't expect it to be over that soon. Ah. Well, we can take out a load more armored and light cruisers. Yep, not too bad. I think I was quite nicely executed. Right then. So, all of these armored cruisers need to go back to port. Right then. Yeah, let's just carry on. I was thinking about maybe designing a new light cruiser, but I think this one's perfectly acceptable at the moment. Right, I didn't realise how long this episode's been, so I'm going to end it here and then we'll carry on in the next one. Cheers for watching, guys. Take care. See you soon.